Well, federal Labor has a new boss, a new attitude, or so we're told. It has a brand new look. Kevin Rudd's ministry has been sworn in, but the day was not without its shock with the sudden exit of elder statesman Simon Crean. National Affairs editor Paul Bongiorno joins us now with the details from Canberra. Paul, as far as the ministry goes, is this the best of what was left?
Well, Natasha, it's true that all ministries are compromises, and Kevin Rudd's had to do his fair share with this lineup. He had to defend why he brought his numbers man, Joel Fitzgibbon, back into cabinet after 4 years in the sin bin, and it is hard to see why Jason Clare was demoted. But in the end, you can forget who's in the ministry if your leader isn't resonating with voters. Labor's ministerial merry-go-round has certainly kept the Governor-General busy this year. All smiles as Kevin Rudd puts his stamp on the government.
Colleagues, this is a strong team. I'm proud to lead this team.
His proudest boast, 6 women cabinet ministers.
We'll have the largest number of women of any cabinet in Australia's history.
One face not there, Simon Crean, the 8th cabinet minister to quit. Last week he wanted to be deputy PM. This week, he wants out.
This is a decision that I've come to over a long period of time.
10 of Gillard's cabinet have stayed. Still not impressed, Tony Abbott.
The new ministry isn't even the B team, it's the C team.
4 ministers will be Rudd's campaign commandos, led by Super Elbow, an unprecedented workload, adding communications and the NBN to everything else. Chris Bowen, the new treasurer. Bill Shorten, the persuader for education reform. Tony Burke's the new border guard to sort out boat people. Rudd loyalist Ed Husic becomes a parliamentary secretary and creates history by swearing on the Koran. Other Rudd loyalists rewarded, Joel Fitzgibbon back after 4 years, along with Kim Carr and Richard Marles.
I think everyone deserves to get a second chance.
The departing Simon Crean says he feels vindicated, calling for the leadership switch, and he trusts Kevin Rudd when he says he'll change his ways. Others in Labor keeping their fingers crossed. The recycled PM like a political pot of gold at the end of the rainbow. The average of 3 polls published since the coup has the gap dramatically closing by 10 points. Labor's back in the game.
Not too many days will pass under Kevin Rudd when people feel nostalgic for Julia Gillard.
Especially Liberals. And Kevin Rudd has opened up an instant 14-point lead as preferred Prime Minister over Tony Abbott in the news poll. Looks like the opposition leader is going to have to grapple with the enduring mystery of Kevin Rudd's popularity.
Paul, thank you.